Double header Saturday returns to the World Cup, where the first game of the day sees Afghanistan taking on Pakistan in Leeds. It's match number 36. Afghanistan don't really have much to play for other than pride. Pakistan still have a chance to make it to the top four of the league phase. Joining us in previewing this game, we are joined by Mike Hussey in studio. Mike, good to have you with us as always. And also joining us from Skype is Misbah-ul-Haq. Misbah, good to have you. And just I'm throwing it out there for you. I have no more 1992 references to give in this show.
I think Pakistan needs to just fight their own fight now, and no more things from the 1992. Just consider yourself that we are in 2019. So that is important for Pakistan. Go there in the next game, just try to win it convincingly and take another step towards the last four. So that is going to be crucial for Pakistan. You cannot take anything, any match lightly, because Afghanistan, the way they performed against India and the way they did against Pakistan in the warm-up match, Pakistan should be aware of that fact. They got world-class mystery spinners in their lineup, so we need to be really clinical at our best.
Yep, we are clearly in 2019, 1992 out of the story, 2019 presently over here. Mike, you were just talking to Misbah before the show started, and you were saying you think they've got a very good chance, Pakistan, of making the Final Four.
I do think they've got the best chance out of the challenges, because I think if Pakistan win their last two matches, which they'd be favoured to do, and then all they'd probably need is really England to lose one of their last two matches, and they've got two tough matches ahead. So I'd say Pakistan are probably looking good, I guess, but I actually see this as a potential danger game for Pakistan. Because the last two matches Pakistan have played, they've been really upbeat, the energy's been amazing, their intensity at the game has been phenomenal. It's hard to maintain that, and they're probably thinking, okay, we're favourites in this game, we've been going well, we just need to relax a little bit. If they do just mentally relax, then that might just see Afghanistan come into the game, because as Misbah mentioned, they've got some quality mystery spinners in their order, and they can be really tricky to play. It's just whether the Afghan batsmen can handle particularly the pace of this Pakistan team, which look to be in really good form with the ball at the moment.
Right, Misbah, then let's get talking about the team that's still in contention for a Final Four spot of the World Cup. You're playing 11 from that last game. Are you changing anything?
I don't think so. I think we need to just persist with the same team, unless the conditions clearly suggest that we need another seamer. Otherwise, I don't think so.
Misbah, word on, of course, your heroes from that last game. Babar Azam, of course, getting all the credit for that amazing century. But would you reckon that ever since this turnaround for Pakistan has happened, it's happened because you've got someone like a Haris Sohail in the middle, and he gives you that solidity in the middle order?
Yeah, I mean, Haris, he came into the squad way before the 2015 World Cup, and the way he played in Australia in that World Cup, he was clearly the one who looked the most comfortable in those sort of conditions. Or he scored consistently. After that, he dropped from the team because of the injury, not because of the performance. He got his knee injured, and then he suffered rehab and whatever, and then he just got back in the team and scored a lot of runs. So it was really surprising for me that he wasn't picked in the playing 11 right from the start because of two senior players. But now I think he's back, and he's just playing with that flair again, and he's just giving consistent performances for Pakistan. That gives you a lot of confidence as a batting unit. Obviously, if somebody's playing at the top three, four, obviously they know that someone is sitting behind and he's in a good nick, and he's performing like that. That gives the top order, especially the top three, a lot of confidence and freedom to go there and just play their normal game.
Misbah, finally a word on Pakistan's bowling, and with that we're focusing on a certain Shadab Khan, and we'll show you just how important he is to this team Pakistan, because when Shadab is taking wickets, that win percentage for Pakistan rises. You see that in wins, 3 innings, 6 wickets to his name. Shadab Khan, of course, has got 6 wickets, economy of 5.2. In losses, 0 wickets, the economy is of course close to 7. So clearly what he's bringing to you with, Harris is bringing to you in the middle overs with the bat, Shadab is kind of doing that with the ball for Pakistan.
Yeah, obviously, he is a critical factor in the middle overs, and that's what he needs to do. I think he can still improve what he has already done in the previous games, especially when even Pakistan won. And even in the last game, the way it was turning and the way he was bowling, I think he could have managed to take a couple of more wickets. I think the key for Shadab is bowl stump to stump, especially to the right-handers. And again, I mean, in the last game against New Zealand, when Jimmy Neesham was playing, I thought he just stayed over the wicket for such a long time. Once you're bowling on that sort of pitch where it's a lot of turn, and especially you just had a used pitch where there is a rough outside off stump, you can just think of bowling like in a test match. You just go round the wicket and just try to bowl in those rough areas and try to bring that bowl decision and slip into play. He could have done much better than that, but the way he bowled, I mean, that was a key for us, especially against England and against New Zealand.
Thanks for that, Misbah. Do stay with us because we have to get your predictions still on the show. Time now to talk all things Afghanistan. We've got Mike in the house. Mike, you're playing 11, firstly.
Yeah, I'm actually going to stick with the same playing 11. I think Afghanistan have really improved their game. In the last couple of matches, they've been really competitive, nicely balanced side. Obviously, they rely heavily on the spin department, and that's their strength. Dolat Zadran came in the last match. Need him just to up his output just a little bit. He's been sort of a little bit in and out, but he's a decent bowler as well. But I wouldn't be looking to change too much. I think they just need a bit of solidarity. They need probably a couple of guys in the top order also just to fire and get a... If someone can get a 70 or an 80 or something, then that'll put a decent score on the board. But it's certainly going to be challenging against what is a very, very good Pakistan team.
You clearly know they're struggling with the bat. And of course, there is one form that is bowling that is, of course, much better than the batting. Mm. Win the toss and back your bowling, or win the toss, bat first and then back your bowling?
It's a difficult one. You've got to look at the conditions first and see what suits the team or suits the best chance of winning the match. But it is disappointing to see no hundreds there and only the 450. So coming into the tournament, we knew that was going to be an issue. So if they can somehow just get some partnerships together, and that's why we've tried to lengthen that batting order as long as possible. Najee Buller, I think, was batting 7 or 8 in the last match, you know, so they're trying to lengthen it as much as they can because they know that's a problem area. As I said, it's not going to be easy against Pakistan, who are, you know, in good form with the ball in particular, but they've got to find a way somehow to get some partnerships together, put a half-decent score on the board, and then maybe let their spinners go to work.
Yeah, you spoke about their spinners now, Mike. We've got a couple of numbers, and I can't seem to put my head around it. I just can't seem to understand how we've got these numbers, because Afghanistan spinners versus Asian teams, that average is 21.8, but versus other teams, that average is about, you know, it's huge. Can't seem to get it, because Asian teams generally play spin better.
They normally do, don't they? But probably the inflated average for the other teams probably comes down to that England game.
Yeah.
When England scored just under 400 runs and Rashid Khan went for so many runs. So it's probably been a little bit inflated because of that particular match. But yeah, it is a little bit strange, I must admit. It might come down to where the games were played. You know, it looked a lot harder for batting against the spinners down in a place in Southampton, like at the Rose Bowl, as opposed to that England match where it just seemed like a beautiful batting pitch, not much spin, and the batters were able to hit through the line pretty easy. So I don't like to look into the stats too much. What we're seeing at the moment is this Afghanistan team are bowling quite well. That they really troubled India in particular. They made it very, very difficult, especially the spinners. So they actually look like they're coming into some good form with the ball at the back end of the tournament. And they're going to be desperate. You know, they desperately want a win. And this would be a big scalp for them. If they could take this this win against Pakistan back home, their fans would be absolutely delighted.
Misbah, final word with you. I mean, of course, Pakistan needs to get the win, but you reckon they need to get a win by a big margin so that that net run rate is also looking pretty good when it comes to the end on deciding who that top four is?
I think it's important first to win the game, because sometimes what happens if you're just thinking that much ahead of the game, you just put yourself in trouble. And Pakistan just needs to just look at that factor during the game. You should just start the way you are playing, a disciplined game, disciplined performance right from the start. And then while you are in between the game, you see if there is opportunity that we can just win convincingly, or we can just pick up our net run rate, then you can obviously go for that. But right from the start, if you are thinking like that, that might just put yourself, some sort of putting yourself under pressure, and you just start making mistakes, and you just put yourself in a lot of trouble sometimes. So what I suggest, right from the start, go only thinking that we have to win this game, and just think about 100 overs. And then obviously, if there is opportunity, just try to grab it and finish it as quickly as possible, so we can just manage to get our run rate better and better.
Misbah-ul-Haq, Michael Hussey, thank you so much for joining us as we were previewing the first game on Super Doubleheader Saturday, Pakistan taking on Afghanistan.
Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and leave your comments in the comment section below. Click on the bell icon for notifications.